Nothing says city more than skyscraper. These vertical structures dominate the skylines and completely characterize a city. These tall steel frame buildings have become synonymous with urban landscapes, symbolizing the emergence of cities on the global stage. However, for thousands of years, cities existed without these towering structures. The Great Pyramid of Giza stood as the world's tallest structure for millennia, representing the power of pharaohs and Egyptian engineering. In the 14th century, church spires began to surpass its height, with Lincoln Cathedral in England reaching 525 feet in 1311. Subsequently, church towers held the height record until the Washington Monument at 555 feet tall and the 1,063 feet Eiffel Tower took over. The Eiffel Tower's steel skeleton, enabling thinner walls, increased glass usage, and supported by the innovative use of high-quality metal production and safe elevators, laid the groundwork for the modern skyscraper. So, what city can lay claim to the birth of the skyscraper? You're probably thinking New York. You'd be wrong. Hong Kong? Wrong again. Prepare to be amazed as we take you on a journey through the city that defies gravity. The city of big shoulders, Chicago, the home of the skyscraper. Today, we're going to unravel the captivating tale of how Chicago claimed its rightful title as the epicenter of the skyscraper revolution. We'll explain exactly how Chicago's rise as the home of the skyscraper can be attributed to its unique historical circumstances, geographic location, technological advancements, and the innovative spirit of its architects and engineers. First, let's dive deeper into the history and details that contributed to Chicago's status as the birthplace of the skyscraper phenomenon. One pivotal event that shaped Chicago's architectural landscape was the Great Fire of 1871. The fire, which began on October 8, 1871, lasted for 2 days, destroying more than 17,000 structures and displacing thousands of residents. This devastating fire destroyed a significant portion of the city, leaving a blank canvas for architects and city planners to reimagine Chicago's urban design. This presented an opportunity to rebuild using new construction techniques and materials, paving the way for the development of tall buildings. The Chicago River, with its strategic location and navigability, played a crucial role in the development of Chicago's skyscrapers. It provided a means of transporting building materials, which significantly reduced construction costs and facilitated the rapid growth of tall buildings. Additionally, Chicago's adoption of the grid plan, introduced in the 1830s, allowed for efficient land use and the consolidation of tall buildings in the downtown area. Next, the late 19th century witnessed remarkable advancements in engineering and construction technology, particularly in the use of steel and the development of the Bessemer process. These innovations made it possible to construct taller and more robust structures, as steel provided superior strength and flexibility compared to traditional building materials like wood. In 1884, architect William Le Baron Jenney had a brilliant idea for a 10-story, 138 feet tall building in Chicago. Instead of relying on traditional load-bearing masonry construction, he designed a strong steel frame as the building's backbone. Completed in 1885, the Home Insurance Building stands as the first steel frame skyscraper in the world. It was like giving the structure an invisible skeleton, allowing it to grow tall without collapsing. Two floors were added in 1891, bringing its now finished height to 180 feet. The Home Insurance Building proudly stood as the world's first skyscraper. It was a marvel of engineering, defying gravity and showing the world what was possible. The Home Insurance Building may seem ordinary today compared to modern skyscrapers, but it will always hold a special place in architectural history. Although the home insurance building was demolished in 1931, it leaves an indelible mark on the world of architecture. Also, a group of influential architects, known as the Chicago School, emerged during this era. Architects such as Louis Sullivan, William LeBaron Jenney, and Daniel Burnham played pivotal roles in shaping the city's architectural landscape. They pioneered new design principles and engineering techniques that would come to define the skyscraper. Louis Sullivan and Dankmar Adler designed the auditorium building in 1886, and it was completed between 1889 and 1890. The auditorium building showcased early skyscraper features. It combined a steel frame, large windows, and vertical emphasis in its design, becoming a symbol of Chicago's architectural prowess. Daniel Burnham and his architectural firm Burnham & Root designed the Monadnock Building in 1889. The Monadnock Building is renowned for its massive masonry construction. The lower half of the building features load-bearing brick walls, while the upper half incorporates a steel frame. This design innovation allowed for a taller structure while maintaining stability. Other buildings would come later, such as the Reliance Building and the Chicago Stock Exchange Building, that also played their part in contributing to the development of modern skyscraper aesthetics. Another factor that contributed to Chicago's embrace of tall buildings was the absence of height and density restriction in the city's early years. Unlike some other cities that imposed strict limitations on building heights, Chicago offered a relatively blank canvas for architectural experimentation. This freedom allowed architects to push the boundaries of height and design, resulting in a dynamic skyline. Chicago's architectural community fostered a competitive environment, encouraging architects to innovate and surpass one another. Architectural competitions, such as the one held for the design of Tribune Tower in the 1920s, showcased the city's commitment to pushing the boundaries of architectural expression. These competitions brought together talented architects from around the world, further solidifying Chicago's reputation as a hub for architectural excellence. As Chicago grew into a major economic and cultural center in the early 20th century, skyscrapers became symbols of the city's prosperity and ambition. The John Hancock Center, completed in 1969 with its distinctive X-bracing system, which provides structural stability and gives it a unique appearance. In 1973, the completion of the Sears Tower, now known as the Willis Tower, marked a milestone in Chicago's skyscraper history. Standing at a height of 1,450 feet, it held the title of the tallest building in the world for 25 years. Today, Chicago's skyline boasts an impressive collection of architectural marvels, like the Aqua Tower, completed in 2009. With its undulating balconies, continue to captivate visitors from around the world. Over the years, Chicago's skyline has evolved and grown, becoming a symbol of the city's ambition and innovation. From the elegant Tribune Tower to the bold Trump International Hotel and Tower, each building tells a story of architectural talent and creativity. In summary, Chicago's ascent as the home of the skyscraper was the result of a combination of historical circumstances, technological advancements, visionary architects, and a culture of innovation. The city's unique geography, competitive environment, and the absence of height restrictions allowed for the birth and evolution of the modern skyscraper. Chicago's iconic cityscape is proof of human ambition, engineering bravery, and the ability to dream big.